Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
This is 7 at 7 from the Las Vegas Review-Journal.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Renee Summerauer. We start off with your top stories brought to you by Nevada Hand's Silver Sky Assisted Living Community. Learn more at NevadaHand.org. An emotional weekend. The community and public officials came together for events honoring the victims of the horrific North Las Vegas car crash and their families. 9 died in the crash, 7 of them from one family.
It's not about any of us individually, it's about us as a collective to come together to be a light in the darkness.
About 100 people attended the candlelight vigil on Sunday, along with officials who pledged to make Nevada roads safer.
While we are standing here today, people are still making decisions to break the laws that we have in place to keep our communities safe. We have an impaired driving problem. We have an excessive speeding problem. And I'm looking forward to working with our Office of Traffic Safety and others to make sure that we can increase our community safety.
And earlier in the weekend, drivers honored the family killed in the crash with a caravan along Cheyenne Avenue and the crash site, with flags waving and the message, "Stop Speed." The parents, Erlinda Zacharias and Jesus Mejia Santana, thank the community for their support. In more news, the Clark County School District is reportedly seeing more students behaving badly. Review Journal's Jen Ah explains why. Jen?
Well, Renee, at the beginning of the school year, school district leaders say they saw as many as a dozen fights per week.
Being distanced and quarantined and in and out can create a lot of concerns, kids need to talk through those concerns with people.
In August, 2 juveniles were arrested after a fight at Green Valley High in Henderson. The next month, fight and gunfire broke out during a football game at Desert Oasis High. In December, a fist fight led to a stabbing involving 2 15-year-olds at Cimarron Memorial High.
They also saw more firearms confiscations on campuses, and as well as more citations.
CCSD's Education Services says 5 officers are now undergoing training through a program called Law Enforcement Against Drugs and Violence. The school district is also holding student safety town halls in schools with upticks in fighting. Renee?
And police arrest New Orleans Saints running back Alvin Kamara for battery after playing in the NFL's Pro Bowl Sunday, the victim reportedly being injured at a nightclub Saturday night. Kamara was booked at Clark County Detention Center Sunday night. His next court appearance is set for March 8th.
Sports brought to you by Station Casinos STN Sports. Download the app today. A very busy sports week in Las Vegas has come to an end after the 2022 Pro Bowl was played right here at Allegiant Stadium. The AFC beat the NFC 41-35, and Raiders' own Max Crosby was named the defensive MVP.
And just this whole experience, you know, it was incredible being around, you know, such incredible talented players, hardworking dudes, and just picking their brains and, you know, just getting some game from them. So it was an incredible experience the whole time.
Sports betting sponsored by Las Vegas Paiute Tribal Smoke and Cigar Shop. Picking the Super Bowl MVP is one of the most popular props at sportsbooks. Rams quarterback Matthew Stafford is the +125 favorite at the Westgate Super Bowl, and Bengals quarterback Joe Burrow is the +250 second choice. Los Angeles wide receiver Cooper Kupp is the 6-1 third pick, followed by defensive tackle Aaron Donald at 14-1, and Cincinnati wideout Jamar Chase at 16-1. Odell Beckham Jr. and Cam Akers are 20-1, and Joe Mixon is 25-1.
Now to today's weather report, brought to you by Star Nursery, your garden's partner for every blooming thing. Happy Monday, everyone. It's going to be a beautiful week with temps warming up. Today's highs will reach around 65 degrees, light winds coming from the northwest. Tonight, evening lows sitting around 42 degrees. For the rest of the week, we're going to stay in the mid-70s, 74 degrees by Wednesday. Light winds sticking around until Tuesday night. Evening lows all week long will be in the mid to upper 40s. Now to your health news. Las Vegas Mayor Carolyn Goodman says she's looking forward to the end of mask mandates. However, the state isn't making moves in that direction at this time. Nevada is reportedly one of 9 states that still require people to wear masks indoors, regardless of vaccine status. Governor Steve Sisolak's medical advisory team says they have not discussed ending or easing the mandate due to the number of COVID cases in the state. In your business news, sponsored by Bank of Nevada, Bank on Accountability, the Mirage's volcano is set to undergo transformation as part of the Hard Rock International's purchase of the property. Review Journal's James Schaefer spoke with tourists to see what they think of the upcoming changes.
An eruption of emotion has come about here as news of plans of the destruction of the Mirage volcano have surfaced. We spoke with locals and tourists to get their reaction to the end of the show.
Sad? Very sad.
The reaction on the Strip was mixed as people lamented the iconic volcano's departure.
Change is good, but some old things are better.
We also showed them what the volcano will be replaced with and asked what they thought of it.
I think that looks gaudy. I think that looks like something that belongs in a men's magazine.
I guess money talks.
But it's hard for me to picture it replacing the Mirage.
There is no official announcement of when the volcano will be removed, but due to unofficial announcements, it does seem to be in the cards. For the Las Vegas Review-Journal, I'm James Schaefer.
In your lifestyle news, what would happen if you won a jackpot and didn't even know it? Well, Nevada Gaming Control Board agents spent 2 weeks tracking down an Arizona man who left Vegas without realizing he won a slot machine jackpot worth $229,000. Robert Taylor won the jackpot at Treasure Island on January 8th, but because of a glitch, no one could determine whether he had won. Taylor collected his winnings this past weekend. In your entertainment news, sponsored by DiscoverYourNevada.com, brought to you by Travel Nevada, the band's visit is about human connection and, quote, everybody is learning something. That's according to actor Sazone Gabay, who's leading the award-winning musical. You can see it at the Smith Center from the 15th to the 20th. And it's been a brutal week for Carlos Santana, according to his manager. He had to cancel his show at House of Blues last week because of food poisoning. And then this weekend's shows were wiped out because of COVID. Santana tweeted that he and his band all tested positive for COVID on Friday. The rock legend's next series at House of Blues begins in May. Thank you for watching 7 at 7 a.m. I'm Renee Summerauer. If you have a Roku device, search Review Journal to download our channel. Watch Las Vegas breaking news streaming live on your OTT device. We'll see you back here later today for 7 at 7 p.m. from the Las Vegas Review-Journal. Have a great day.
Review-Journal Studio, sponsored by Adam Kuttner. Get the maximum settlement as quickly as possible. This 7 at 7 update, sponsored by Pro Group Management. You're watching 7 at 7 from the Las Vegas Review-Journal.